The world is undergoing tremendous challenges owing to the impact of the coronavirus disease, and people of all faiths have not been spared. Our schools, our places of work, including our places of worship, have been disrupted by measures that have been put in place to contain the spread and to manage this disease. Suspension of religious activity that entail congregation is unprecedented in our time and has taken us to uncharted territory. It has never happened in our time that we cannot go to our places of worship. We, however, take comfort in the fact that our religious freedom remain intact and that we can worship and serve God notwithstanding these disruptions. The Muslim faithfuls will usher in the holy month of Ramadan at this time of profound anxiety and uncertainty. Fortunately for the Ummah, the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, in the 14th century, taught faithful not only the practice of rigorous hygiene, but also specific measures to be taken in pestilence. This includes isolation and restriction of movement into and out of areas that are affected. We are thankful for the opportunity to reflect on the Holy Prophet's teaching as we make sense of these troubling times. Many people face mounting challenges on account of loss of work and income, affecting their ability to meet their needs and those of their families. During the holy month, this situation will continue to be grave. The spirit of Ramadan, however, calls us to rekindle compassion and charity, and to reach out to our less fortunate brothers and sisters. The culture of solidarity, uniting the Muslim faithful, will be crucial in mitigating the painful disruption brought about by the corona disease outbreak. The faithful and all of us Kenyans are enjoined to extend charity and care to those in need amongst us. The Holy Quran teaches us that God loves most those who help others in need, and that we do not lose when we give, but rather our honor and status increase with charitable deeds. We wish you, our Muslim brothers and sisters, peace as you embark upon the period of great sacrifice, reflection, and devotion, and hope that your good deeds will give us relief from our tribulations. As you faithfully observe this important pillar of your faith, I urge each one of you to pray for our nation, Kenya, that God may have mercy upon us, and that he may extend blessings to us and our neighbors for peace, unity, and prosperity. I also urge you to be more vigilant and meticulous in observing the guidelines and protocols issued by our health experts until we overcome this pandemic. The government of Kenya will continue to do its best in mitigating the impact of the pandemic while implementing measures to control its spread. From my family and I, Ramadan Karim, Wasaum Makbul.